Okay guys, as promised, I'm making this video to explain the lesson on derivative and differentiability. Make sure you pay extra attention to these details because this is a very important concept. So let's talk about function f is differentiable. Differentiable means slope exists, derivative exists, if the derivative of f exists at x equal to c. So word differentiable means everywhere the derivative exists. In order for derivative to exist, graph must have a local linearity. So what is a local linearity means? When you zoom in, over and over and over, the graph looks like a line, but not a vertical line. So, for example, if I have a graph here and if I continue zoom in in this box so many times, it looks like a straight line. That's what locally linear means. Okay, so let's talk about differentiability at point C. So function f of x is differentiable if and only if limit x approaches c, f of x minus f of c over x minus c. This is nothing but the slope from the left side. As x approaches c from the right, they both has to be same, and it has to be a number, a real number, finite value. So in other words, a function is differentiable when you go from the left and right, the slope merges smoothly. I use the word that here, the slopes merge smoothly. That means merge into each other. The slope is, it merges smoothly from, like smoothly the slope merges. So in other words, there should not be any sharp corners. That's the easiest way to see. So this basically says the function is differentiable at a point where function has to be continuous, connected, but must connect it in a way that the slope merges smoothly. So several multiple choice question comes here. Okay, so let's talk about these statements. These statements summarize the relationship between continuity and differentiability. So let's talk about these statements. Multiple choice question, they are very tricky. If function is differentiable, then it is continuous. Differentiability implies continuity. Free response questions, many times they give you f of x is differentiable. F of x is differentiable, then it has to be continuous at x equal to c. Now, it is possible for function to be continuous at x equal to c, but not differentiable. So continuous, that does not mean differentiable, but differentiable means continuous. It's always one way. Differentiable, continuous, but continuous, not necessarily differentiable. So continuity does not imply differentiability. So let's take a look at a couple of examples here we have. And from the graph and from the equations here. So you should be able to see both ways from the graph and from the equations. So here is the first example, absolute value x minus 2. We can clearly see that on the x is less than 2, the slope is negative. X is greater than 2, slope is positive. And we can say that the function is not differentiable at x equal to 2 because there is a sharp turn. Now, here is the thing. This is only for understanding. Do not use this. Must use limit statement. Must use limit statement. Many times in FRQ it says it's justify why function is not differentiable. So what statement you are looking at, that limit x approaches 2 from the left f of x minus f of c over x minus c is not same as limit x approaches 2 from the right. This tells you that slope from the left is not the same as slope from the right. This is telling you that the slope from the left is not same as slope from the right. Now, of course, the c value is a 2. So, this should be 2. If you don't want to use the limit statement, you will have to justify that when x is less than 2, the slope is negative 1. When x is greater than 2, slope is positive 1. And negative 1 is not same as positive 1. Okay, so this is one kind of function where function is not differentiable. Sharp turn is only for our understanding, not for writing. Okay, so whenever there is a vertical asymptote, function is not differentiable because there is a, this is very silly, easiest way, vertical asymptote, x is equal to 2, therefore function is f prime of 2 is, does not exist. F prime of 2 is, does not exist, function is not differentiable at 2. Okay, so let's take a look at the third example here. Now, notice that the cubic function and a cubed root. Cubed root is sideways and a cubic function also has a similar shape. Now, this function is not differentiable at x equal to 1 because there is a vertical tangent. Later on, we are going to learn the algebraic method, what is f prime of x, and then we will see that the division by 0 is not defined and you can clearly see there is a vertical tangent at x equal to 1. So, if I use the same strategy here, let's try to sketch the tangent line here. If I try to draw the tangent line here and tangent line here, there is no way they are going to merge into each other. So, this will never merge smoothly. It's not going to merge smoothly. This will be, if line does not exist, of course, they are not going to merge, vertical line. This again, vertical line tangent, that's why it's not differentiable. Watch out, x to the 1/3, any 1/3 power, they are not going to be differentiable at, this is the 1, but this would be 0. 1/3 power, cubic, cubed root, you have to be very careful. There is always a vertical tangent. Now, this is a cusp. Check it out, 2/3. 2/3 is, this is a 1/3. If I take a square of this function, this piece reflects on the other side, and I get the cusp. So, function is not differentiable. No matter how many times would you zoom in, you will not be able to get the smooth curve here. So, that's why it's not differentiable. Pay extra attention to the 2/3 power and 1/3 power. 2/3, 1/3 looks like this, and the 2/3, this graph comes up, and there is a sharp turn, cusp. No matter how many times you zoom in, you will never see any smooth curve here. So these are the four examples where function is not differentiable. Okay, so let's take a look at how do we prove using definition of derivative. How do we prove using definition of derivative? You are not allowed to write that the limit and the slope from the left and right. How do we use definition of derivative? So I'm going to show you some work here. Remember, you do not have to do for every single problem. This is just the beginning of the lessons and we are trying to make some connections to the limit. So here, limit x approaches 2 from the left. If I use the definition of derivative, f of x, that's a handy here, minus f of 2 over x minus 2. What I will get here is limit x approaches 2 from the left. F of x is absolute x minus f of 2 is 0 divided by x minus 2. Does this look familiar? We have seen this before. What this is, limit x approaches. Remember that function which looks like, so this is the answer is 2 from the left is negative 1. If I apply same limit x approaches 2 from the right, f of x minus f of 2 over x minus 2, f of x is x minus 2 minus 0, x minus 2. If I bring the limit statement, this answer will be positive 1. Now, slope from this side is negative 1. Slope from this side is positive 1. They are not same. Therefore, function f of x is not differentiable at x is equal to 2. This is what we are looking for, limit statements, using limits, proving that function is not differentiable at x equal to 2. So this helps us to get a new rule that if you have f of x is absolute x over x, then f prime of x is a piecewise function, 1 when x is greater than 0, negative 1 when x is less than 0. This is the derivative of absolute x over, the derivative of absolute x. F of x is absolute x. F prime of x is piecewise function. F prime of x will be piecewise function. One side is a slope is a 1, the other side slope is negative 1. Okay, so let's talk about cubed root. Cubed root. We said that y function is not differentiable. Why? We prove it, just not because looking at the graph and there is a sharp turn. We must use the limit definition of derivative. Limit x approaches 0 from the left. F of x minus f of 0 over x minus 0. Limit x approaches 0 from the left. Cubed root of x minus 0 over x. What do we get here if we simplify this? Cubed root is a 1/3 and this is 1. If I simplify, I get 1 over x to the 2/3. Remember, cubed root is x to the 1/3. I'm not going to teach you how do you simplify this piece. 1/3 over 1, you subtract the exponent, you get in the denominator 2/3. Limit x approaches 0 from the left, something 1 over 0 is, does not exist. This would be, does not exist. Infinity. You can try the same thing again. Limit x approaches 0 from the right, which will be the same answer. You don't really have to do the both sides. One of them is undefined. You can say there is a vertical tangent at x equal to 0. You don't have to really write f of x is not f prime of x is not defined at x equal to 0. And this is actually a definition of derivative. So this is giving you f prime of 0. This is giving you the definition of derivative. If f prime of 0 does not exist, that means function is not defined at x equal to 0. This is nothing but the derivative at x equal to 0 using alternate form. Confirming graphically, you can say that. That's a confirming graphically. We already showed you on the other side. That's not possible. My graph is not very accurate, but if you sketch on the nicely on the calculator, you will be able to see. So let's prove with x to the 2/3 function is not differentiable. So at x equal to 0, let's try to find derivative at 0. Limit x approaches 0 from the left. F of x minus f of 0 over x minus 0. Limit x approaches 0 from the left is x to the 2/3. F of 0 is 0 over x. If one side does not exist, you don't have to do on the other side. So this will give you 1 over x to the 1/3, which will be does not exist. Therefore, f of x, x to the 2/3 is not differentiable at x equal to 0. In other words, f prime of 0 does not exist. Function is not differentiable at x equal to 0. Okay, so specific which cases where the function fails to differentiate? Well, all those three cases we already saw that whenever there is a vertical asymptote, whenever there is a absolute value function, you can say that. Absolute value functions. Third is a cubed root or odd root. Odd root. You can say there is an odd root. That means there is a cusp. X to the 1/3, x to the 2/3, x to the 1/5. You can say that. You can try all of these functions to see if there is a cusp. Vertical tangent function failed to be differentiated. So we have this is the finding the value of this. I have been saying that you don't have to memorize, you have to memorize the definition of derivative. You have to memorize the definition of derivative. I'm not asking you to evaluate this. You do not have to evaluate this. You just have to spot what it's asking for, what this is asking for, what is f of x. So I'm going to write those definitions here. Definitions of derivative is f prime of c is limit x approaches c, f of x minus f of c over x minus c. There is another formula for f prime of c is limit, there is a h1, h approaches 0. Notice that this is h approaches 0, f of x, c, x is replaced by c plus h minus f of c. So let's use this. Okay, so here, identify f of x. What is f of x? So I'm trying to write down here. This is h. So this is the second formula. So let's say this is my f of x plus h minus f of c. This is c. So c is what? What is f of c? Is negative 2. And this is, can we identify what is f of x going to be? Okay, so I'm writing one more time. C plus h is 5 minus 3 times 1 plus h. Can I say f of x is 5 minus 3x? And the c is 1. Compare that f of x plus h and c is going to be 1. So what this is giving you? This is giving you what this means, f prime of 2. What this is actually giving you, let's talk about here. F of x plus h minus f of c, this is c. C is negative 2. You recognize the function. If you recognize the function is x cube minus, because f of negative 2 is negative 8. So you rewrite this with negative sign. These bottom ones are a little bit easier. You can easily see. X approaches c. C is a 6. This is f of x minus f of c, x minus c. So f of x is negative x squared, c is 6. And this value gives you f prime of c, derivative at 6. This gives you f prime of 9. What this is, derivatives, definition of derivative. F prime of 9, f of x is 2 square root x. c is none. F of x minus f of c, x minus c. Okay, so the last piece, and then I'm going to stop here. These are the multiple choice questions, true or false. Okay, so let's read carefully. If a slope of the tangent line to the differentiable function is then f of 2 plus h minus f of 2 over h. This is if the slope is 2 and f of 2, differentiable function. Here we have to say that limit h approaches 0. Then only it becomes true function. Definition of derivative at 2. Definition of derivative. Then only it becomes true. Function is continuous, then it is differentiable. No. Continuity does not imply differentiability. Differentiable, continuous. Yes. Differentiable, continuous. But continuous, differentiable. Big, no. Okay, so let's talk about the derivative from both left and right. Then it is differentiable. No, this is false because derivative exists, but they are not same. We cannot say differentiable. It has to be same. It has to be same. Derivative from the left and right has to be same. So B, C are false. D is a true statement. Only true statement. This will be true with limit statement. With limit statement, then only we can say true. So I'm going to stop here. Let's see. I have a next one. Okay, so I highly recommend that you take a look at the page number 10, the notes I have posted in the classroom. I'm going to post the notes in the classroom. Page number 10 is not a homework, but I would highly recommend that you take a look at the notes. This is not a homework. Later on, we will have some easy way to find the derivatives. And when we have an easy way to find derivatives, we never revisit this. So due to pandemic and we have to cut down certain things, so I'm not going to make you, which is a good news for you all, I'm not going to make you do the derivative this long way. Okay, so this video covers the notes from page number 7, 8 and 9. Page number 10 is the optional. I will see you in the class. Thank you.